Drew here. Welcome back to Drew's Custom Diecast. Well, today I'm throwing out another challenge. This one I think is a pretty good one. It's going to be a police car challenge. Let's see 10 cop cars. You know, it doesn't matter if it's Hot Wheels, Matchbox, green light, doesn't matter. Any kind of patrol car, it'd be a detective's car. Along with even retired cop cars. With that said, let's kick this off. And let's kick it off with Roscoe's car from the Dukes of Hazzard. Yeah, this is what I picked up. Yeah. This is the green light. Really cool car. I really dig it. They did a pretty good job on it. It's a lot like the car that generally jumps at the very beginning, doesn't it? Yeah. Yes, and that's got me onto the fact that, yes, I've got two General Lees that need to be finished up. It's been waiting forever, and I've got everything to do, fix them now, and just need to do it, huh? So, with that said, you know, there's Roscoe's patrol car. From number two, we'll go with the Matchbox California Highway Patrol Dodge Monaco. It is a really, really sharp looking car. You know, I added details on it because it just looked naked and kind of boring without it, even though it's a super great casting, which I really do. One of my all-time favorite Matchbox castings. And the details just make that much better. Yeah. Only thing I think is a little bit off is the track is just a little bit too narrow. That could be solved. But I do love it like it is. That said, that's number two. Number three. Green light. SSP Black Bandit Mustang. Did a pretty good job on this car. Really looks like something you'd see from the early, you know, the mid to late 80s running around. I mean, he even did, you know, details. He did the mirrors on it. He really did a good job on this car. He got, where's the hood open this one? No, it doesn't. Couldn't remember if the hood opened or not. You know, you can't really see much in the doors, but, you know, yeah, that's the flat black, and then you got the Black Bandit insignia in it. It's pretty good. And we got number three here. For number four, we have Terminator. I don't know if it's T2 or T1 right now, but this was the Chevy Caprice cop car from the Terminator series of movies. I don't remember which one Greenlight says this is from, but did a really good job on it. I mean, the details are really good, really sharp, really sweet looking car. I really like it. And that's number four. Number five, another Terminator police car. Their Dodge Monaco. They did a really good job on this. Details are spot on. Hubcaps look really on, you know, did a great job. And it's technically, I think it's probably the heaviest casting I got. I mean, this got weight to it. I mean, I was stunned. I mean, it outweighs any other casting I have. So, if I remember right, she does have an opening hood. You can see that nice, luscious Chrysler big block stuffed underneath there, which for this year would have been a 400 Magnum motor, which wasn't a bad motor. And, you know, some people give it a bad rep, but I liked them. Had one at a 75 Newport, which is wicked as could be. and I thought it was a taxi that I drove. Yep, I'd get you where you need to go, and I got you there quick. And from there, we'll go with the highway, the California Highway Patrol, SSP Mustang, from Green Light. It's a really good looking car, I think. Again, they nailed the details on it. Great job. Actually, girls, not too bad for Green Light. See, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 6. And here's number 7. Detective Jenkins' car from the movie Christine. Yeah, this is the cop who tried, who questions Arnie and ends it. They did it. What a good job on his detective's unit. I really dig it. The color is spot on. There were some issues with this one. And the seller I got it from, it wasn't on them. This is, I would say, it was a Green Light's fault. The right front hubcap was missing half of its chrome, and I had to redo it. And then there's little specks throughout the rims that need to be retouched with, like, I guess I'm gonna have to hit it with a black Sharpie, because actually you see chrome popping through in some spots on where the black isn't there on the rims. Just tiny little spots, but enough to say, Green Light, come on, pull your heads out of your butt. And I'm not too thrilled with how they did the window trim. They added, what should be on the doors onto the glass, and that's a little tacky. But overall, still a really good, cool casting. We'll park it up there. From there, we'll go with an iconic Starsky and Hutch Green Light car. Yeah, this is the 76 Torino Green Light Starsky and Hutch. They did a really good job. Only thing I think they're off is back tires are supposed to be a little bit fatter, and she should have just a touch of a rake. But other than that, though, they were on it. They did one of the best jobs. And yes, we got opening hood. Come on, there we go. Which should be ditch. It should probably either be a 351 Windsor, or that'd be the. And judging how that's set up, that's. Ooh, nope, that'd be the 400 modified. Judging from those heads. Yeah, they did a really banging job on it. I mean, details are really sweet. I like it. Hey, now number 9 will be the 1974 AMC Matador for the Milwaukee Police Department. Did a really good job on it. I thought the lights, the light bar, and the light, the siren was kind of ugly, but that was kind of a style back in that day. In the day, yeah. Some police agencies, whether it be local, state, or whatnot, used that big, giant, ugly thing for a while. Man, was that ugly. Oh, but other than that, oh, it's a really cool car. Great, great details in it. I mean, I really like it. For a Green Light, it rolls all right. All right, we have this number 9. And number 10 will be my Matchbox Mustang patrol unit that I made. That I did on the for my channel. I have kind of went read back through it. Had to go back over some of the details were a little off. It kind of faded a little bit. And made it look pretty sharp again. It's a fun little car to build. I made it look like an unmarked Missouri Highway Patrol, and I thought it came out pretty good. Well, guys, that was 10 of them. Now, I'm actually going to give you guys a bonus. Yep, number 11. And it's probably one of the most iconic cars of all time. And that is the 1974 Dodge Monaco, driven by the Blues Brothers. Yes, the Bluesmobiles, guys. My green light, and they did a banging job on this car. I mean, it is so sweet, so cool. I love it. Details are spot on. You know, it's got the cop tires, cop shocks, cop brakes, cop motor, 440 plant, which pop that hood. You know, you can't really see a whole lot of it, but yes, there's supposed to be a 440 underneath there. Yeah, they did a really great job. Only thing I can see that slack is off is the Bluesmobile was actually a California Highway Patrol car in real life, and it had a tan interior. Oops. I don't think they thought about that when they built it. And then there's not a bunch of stuff across the dash. You know, there should be a ton of sunglasses, cigarette packs, and whatnot all lined across the dash. But though, I can't complain. Other than that, it's really cool. I love it. Did a great job. It really looks like an old Mount Prospect police vehicle. Yep. Would have been, you know, that Jake and Elwood drove. So, that's it. There's my police car challenge, guys. I hope you like it. If you do, hit that like button. Subscribe. You know. And then let's see your guys' cop cars. Let's see what you guys got. All right. Take care. Have a great one.